Hi, thank you for watching a new video blog. Near-death experiences. Can they be debunked? When I talk about near-death experiences, I see that many people are skeptical. If you haven't really read deep into the topic, then they're quite skeptical. They'll say, you know, it's just hallucinations, just people are imagining things. It's not real. It's maybe a survival mechanism of the brain so that you can die more peacefully, so that dying is not a bad feeling eventually. So, but for what I noticed is that once your brain stops working, when there's no oxygen anymore in your brain, then there is no brain activity. So it's also not possible to have hallucinations. Because for hallucinations, you really need a functioning brain. Your brain is still working. It's not working correctly, but it is working. There is activity. So that means that a near-death experience is not the same as a hallucination. Because with a near-death experience, the brain stopped working completely. There is no brain activity. And now I personally, my skepticism will be more like, okay, maybe the brain is not working, but maybe just, you know, when you get something out of the oven, like a bread, you bake the bread and now it's warm and you need to cool it down. Isn't that maybe what can cause a near-death experience? Like, your brain is cooling down and that is dead activity. That's seriously a question that I have. Could it be that? It was a question that was running through my mind, but soon I discovered that, wait a minute, these people say that, you know, they're dead. We know that they're dead. There's no brain activity. Okay, so maybe the brain is cooling down, but their conscious is more clear, stronger than ever. They have even like talents to read people's minds, to hear that what they're thinking. So it's not like, oh, okay, it's cooling down, you know, like and maybe they see a little bit of things. No, it is actually more clear, more focused. They are aware of themselves, and that's not possible when you are basically brain dead, because then there is no activity. So it must be something else. And I also still have questions, and I also still am not 100% convinced, but I am very convinced about this. Like I say, this idea of maybe it's just cooling down and then you get this effect or something that, you know, because your brain is cooling down, so then you get this effect. But yeah, like I say, it's not possible when you're clinically dead, when your brain is clinically finished. So yeah, I have a tendency to really believe that it is real. Like I say, I am convinced, but always, like, I'm also somebody that is born into this world of skepticism against anything that is spiritual. But I am very convinced that it's not possible when you are basically brain dead, when your body's not functioning anymore, that suddenly you just shift conscious. Maybe, okay, your body is not working anymore, but your conscious is working, and they can see. Not like we see with our eyes, but they see in their, maybe you could compare it like they're now part of the web, of the connection of energy. So they can see everything. We can only see on the surface. We can see, okay, you have the skin of somebody, or we can see the tree, the outside, the color, but we don't see the energy of the tree. We don't see what's going on in the tree, in the roots of the tree. We don't have this ability. So, skepticism, I can understand. It's always good to ask questions because you want to know the truth. That's it. I am open for the truth. I want to hear the truth, so I'm open for arguments. And if I feel that an argument is right, like it makes sense, I can make a connection, I can see, yeah, this goes further than just a thought. But it's backed up by reality and by things that you cannot explain other than something else is going on. Yet then I am open to be convinced for the truth. And I now start to be probably almost 100% convinced that, yeah, this is true. What these people experience is what happens when you die. You let loose of the flesh, but your conscious, your energy stays. You're just shifting. It makes sense, because how can an energy, that's you, you are an energy. You remember the Matrix, where they say, oh, the human body is a battery. So much energy as just a small battery. Yeah, where does it go? Is it just like gone? Like what the atheists want you to believe? Like it's gone? Or is it just letting go? Are you going back? Are you zooming out? Are you going back into the network of energy, of nature, of spiritual nature? Because what we have here is material nature, but it's connected to the spiritual world. So I understand that for many people that are just discovering this topic, it is a very complicated story. And they are filled with skepticism. And one of the skepticisms is, like they say, maybe they're hallucinating, or maybe they're on drugs. But also, being on drugs and getting like hallucinations or fantasies or whatever, your brain still needs to be functioning 100%. You cannot have this with a dead brain. It's not possible. So you need to have activity in your brain. And near that experience, your brain stops. It's completely. You can... None of the functions, also the basic functions, like when you stick, you know, when you touch somebody's eye, you know, you will directly react to it. It's not possible. It's not working. Even the most basic things are dead, are stopped functioning. So it is not a hallucination, because then your brain really needs to be completely functioning. Maybe your brain's damaged, and then you can also have like strange hallucinations. But then, or things happening in your brain. But that is not what is happening, because the brain is beep, it's gone. There is nothing going on in your brain. It's just stopped. So that is my answer to skepticism about near-death experiences. They're not hallucinations, because for hallucinations you need a functioning brain. They're not caused by drugs, because hallucinations caused by drugs, you need to have a functioning brain. The fact is that near-death experience happens when you have a non-functioning brain. It's not working. So, that was it for today. Thank you for watching. See you next time.